And I'm going to take control here and tell our crew, let's turn off the studio lights that we have out here because we don't want to have any false illumination. This is how it really looks. It's getting dark. We have Chris Hartenstein here. Wow, is it getting dark, from NASA Glenn. Right now it's 3:11, Chris. This is where you wanted to talk about something called Bailey's beads, correct?
Yes. So Bailey's beads effect is a really cool phenomenon, which is the last glimmers of sunlight are shining through the craters on the edges of the moon. So the very edge of the surface around the disk of the moon, there are little imperfections, just enough to be able to see those light shine through. The last of those becomes what's known as the diamond ring. So you will see a glimmer of light, one bright shine, and a ring around the moon right before we go out of totality.
Wow.
Okay, Chris, put your glasses on.
There it is. Look at that, Chris.
Tell us what you are seeing here. It is now 3:12, and you could just see a little sliver, and now we want to look for the beads, right?
Yeah, so we are still in the very last sliver here. This part goes really, really fast, and we're going to get to totality, so the excitement builds up. Even with the headset on, I can hear the audience starting to hoot and holler.
Yes.
Get people cheering. The temperature has significantly dropped. I'm already feeling that. So there's so many things going on all at the same time. And just even being able to see, like, images, the shadows are sharper, the cutouts around people and things are all sharper right around us. So it's a really eerie phenomenon, and it's so cool, and we are in the last little bits here. You'll get to see them coming up very, very soon.
We are so grateful to have Chris here with us today, not only because he knows everything there is to know about the eclipse, he's with NASA Glenn, but he's seen it once before in 2017, and it was the event of a lifetime for you, wasn't it?
Oh, it was. 2017 was phenomenal. We were out in the middle of Jefferson City, Missouri in August.
Here we go, Chris. Here we go.
Oh, my gosh.
So it is getting really close.
Is that the diamond?
So we're getting even just a little bit more here.
Just a
little
bit.
And we're seeing those little edges starting to shine out. Look at that. And we get the last little glimmer here.
And
oh, man, everybody is screaming out behind us.
It is
absolutely phenomenal.
I am loving, Chris, hearing all these people, thousands and thousands of people, witnessing something they've never seen before and will never see again. Here it is. We're on the countdown now, the final countdown.
This is so incredible.
All right.
And so, to think this is only going to last like 4 minutes, right?
Yes, 3 minutes and 50 seconds. So we are in now. We can take off. Oh, my gosh. Look at the atmosphere.
Oh, my gosh.
You can see it glowing across. Look at that ring.
Whoa.
Amazing.
It is absolutely phenomenal. You can see the atmosphere of the sun shining across. I can see we have planets that are actually shining a little bit down and to the right here. So we've got several planets, but that one I believe is Venus that I can see there. You can see, everything, look around you. We have a sunset all around us, no matter which way you look. We have 360 degree sunset, and we have this amazing totality experience. Oh my gosh, it never gets old.
And Chris, this is the time, these are those very few minutes where we could take our glasses off and look at this. This is totality, what we're looking at right now.
Yes, this is totality. It is, oh my God.
The street lights
have come on over on Route 2, so they think that it's nighttime. Yep, and you can take those glasses off. You have to. You can't see anything in totality with the glasses on.
I tell you what, Chris, I wasn't sure exactly what to expect today. We've been reporting on this for so many months now, and I just did not know. There's a live picture from Put-in Bay right now. I didn't know how I would react, but I'm feeling just the way everybody else here is reacting. I just want to let out a roar, a cheer. This is something I'll never, ever see again. It's just a beautiful, beautiful thing.
Looking at the edge, you can actually see prominences off the sun. I can see ejecta off the corona. The chromosphere, that is the thinnest part of the atmosphere, right on against the edge of the surface of the disk of the sun. You can see little bursts out there. I can even see some of it from the naked eye if I look down into the left side.
And it's still safe.
You can see the color coming off of that. That's why it's called the chromosphere.
Wow.
You can actually see that is a solar prominence, that is ejecta from the atmosphere of the sun.
So after it moves out of Cleveland, where does it go?
Well, we're going heading up toward Erie and toward Rochester and Niagara Falls in New York. But we are down to the last 1 minute and 20 seconds. So Yeah, you want to make sure you take out the last in, you know, take everything in, be able to see it. I think I'm seeing another planet here coming along the same line.
I see it.
Yes,
Chris is pointing up.
Yep.
When you pointed up, I wasn't sure I'd see anything.
Yep, yep.
I can see it right now, too.
Absolutely. So here we are. We're in the middle of the afternoon. It's 3 o'clock in the afternoon. The sun is right in front of us, and we can see planets in the quote-unquote nighttime sky.
And just a few moments ago, we saw a live look from downtown Cleveland, and as you said, all the lights are on. I mean, it looks like it's midnight out here.
Right. It's 50 seconds left, so take it in. This is your last chance to get your last minute in of enjoying this amazing celestial phenomenon.
I'll tell you this, too. Tracy and I get asked all the time, what's the most fun thing you've ever covered, the most meaningful thing you've ever covered? And up until now, we would agree it was, you know, the Indians back in 2016, the convention, whatever. Right now, this is it, Chris, and nothing could ever compare to this. This is just unbelievable.
You see it once, you're sold
yes.
for the rest of your life. It is such an opportunity, and you'll start looking for the next one, that's for sure.
Oh, that's, and again, that red dot that you see there at the bottom, what is that again?
So that is the chromosphere. So you can actually see some solar ejecta, some coronal mass ejections that are actually coming off. They happen all the time. Oh, we've got diamond ring.
Diamond rings. Tell us about diamond rings,
okay,
Chris.
So diamond ring means yeah. we got to get those eyes back and get those.
Oh, get your glasses back on, Trace.
Back on.
Okay.
Yep.
Gosh.
That was it. There we go. We're coming back in. We get those Bailey's beads.
Woo-hoo!
Now, while you get a chance, as you're coming back out, if you get a chance, we want to look on the ground as we get a chance, because we might see what's called some shadow bands. Shadow bands are actually the really focused light of the sky, of the sun that is coming through the atmosphere. You can see the focused light moving. So it's a lot easier to see on the way out than it is to see on the way in. I'm kind of looking for it. It depends on how the cloud
wow.
cover is. But if you look out now, you can see we're already back into partial
yes.
daylight.
It's warming up again. At least it will be soon. And you know what else is neat, Chris? I look at our crew, and they have seen everything, right, over the years. But they're all paying real close attention to this, ooing and eyeing like the rest of us. That is just a marvelous thing to watch.
Yeah. Oh, takes my breath away.
I can see the excitement. I mean, this is like the Super Bowl day for you.
It's as Super Bowl a day as you can get at NASA, other than maybe a launch back to the moon, which we're looking forward to in 2025, but I'm looking forward to it.
And what do you learn from these total eclipses?
Oh, so with eclipses, just like you were able to see the atmosphere of the sun with that without the interference of the big bright disk, we can look at that atmosphere and help predict to create models to predict how solar wind would travel from the sun to us on Earth. And sometimes that solar wind, because it's electromagnetic, can create disruptions in technology and in data telecommunications.
Okay, Chris, where are you traveling to next?
Well, I mean, I'm looking at it, so I know that we've got 20, I'm trying to think of the numbers, man. I'm sorry, my mind is...
That's okay.
But we've got another eclipse coming up, 2044. Is an eclipse, I think, of the Montana, North Dakota.
Okay.
And then 2045, we have another one going British Columbia to Florida. That's the one that I'll be looking forward to doing this again.
I don't know about you, Tracy. I think you'll agree. Having this guy here to paint the word picture of what we were seeing, I could not have done it any better. Absolutely, Chris, spectacular. Thank you for your knowledge, your expertise, and the way you could verbalize just what all of us were feeling.
Well, thank you so much. It's a great pleasure. It's awesome to be able to share this, not just with our fans that are here and all of our spectators,
yeah.
but also to be able to help the viewing audience out there.
Okay, Chris, thank you again for your time. We really appreciate it. And we're going to take a quick break, but we'll have much more coverage from the 2024 total eclipse when we come back.
There is no dark side in the moon, really. Matter of fact, it's all dark.